Hello, I'm Graham and I hope everyone's having a great day. Welcome to today's video. Now if you've been following my channel for a while, you notice I've been shooting with a Huawei P20 Pro camera for a couple of weeks. Now it's the camera that interested me in the phone. I hardly use the phone for any other purpose than taking pictures. So it was the 41 megapixel DNG RAW that attracted me to try the camera. Now, when I first downloaded the images from this particular camera, I was more than disappointed with the actual results. If you look on screen now, you can see an image of a grey car that I shot using the camera in good even lighting, and you can see there's a color shift between center and edge, and it goes cyan-green, and there's also a density shift of about one stop again between center and edge. So it means that any DNG file show this predominance of cyan-green when you're looking at an image, and you can see on screen now one of the shots that I took and very cyan-green, and it means it's almost impossible to correct in post-processing without quite a lot of effort. Now I've not been able to find any profile at all which will allow me to correct this in camera or in the first stages of Lightroom or Photoshop processing. So what I've done is design a set of actions which you can run under Photoshop which will actually go in and correct for this density shift in vignette and correct for that color shading between center and edge. You can only do this in the Photoshop main screen. You can't do it in Camera Raw because that doesn't support actions as far as I'm aware. So I've had to open the DNG, then open the image back into Photoshop, run the action to go back into Camera Raw to make these corrections, and then go back into Photoshop for the final edit. It does sound a long-winded process, but it's really just one click of a play button, and that takes you through into Camera Raw, does the adjustments, and comes back into Photoshop to complete your final edit. So let's go to the screen and show you how these actions have been created. And I'm going to put the action script in the mobile photography page of my photographic blog. I'll put a link to that in the video description below so you can try it out for your camera. If not, then you need to shoot either a white sheet of paper or a grey card in good light and make sure that it completely fills the whole sensor. And then run this action the way that I'm going to show you at the moment, and you should be able to create your own action script which will get over these problems you have with DNG. If you're running JPEGs only, either in the native camera app or in any of the other camera apps such as Lightroom Mobile, you'll find that the JPEGs are handled beautifully by the camera itself. So there is obviously internal processing which is getting rid of this, but there's nothing applied to the DNG out of camera, which is a great pity because that is one of the selling points that I'm sure this camera was aimed at to allow photographers to get better images that they could process themselves. So why we haven't actually given you the facilities or given you a script, I don't know. Well, I'm here in Photoshop and I've just opened the image of the DNG that was created by the camera when I shot a grey card. Now, I tried to illuminate the grey card in even as light as possible. Then I filled the actual complete frame with the grey card so that it was only the grey card showing as the image. So you can see we've got quite a heavy cyan-green outside edge to this particular image with a hot spot which is not quite in the center but near enough for illustration purposes, but you can see we've got these very dark edges and the cyan-y green outside edge. Now there is a write-up of why this is happening in my photographic blog. I'll put a link to that in the video description below if you wanted the full technical reasons why we do get this effect. Looking at that, how it appears on a DNG image from this file, you can see that here is an image that I've shot. Again, we've got this dark cyan-green outside edge. And if we look at another image, again, you can see this dark cyan-green on the outside of the image, and it's darker than the center. So what we're going to do is create a set of actions which will actually reduce those. Now, we are going to record a set of actions, and this will be specific to the particular image that you shot, but you could actually use my action file, and again I'll put a link to that in the video description so you can try it and see how good it is for your particular Huawei P20 camera. So when you first of all open the DNG file, it will open it in Camera Raw, but you can't make this set of actions in Camera Raw, so you need to open the image, come back into Photoshop, and this is the situation you will be in. So we're going to create a set of actions, and you'll use that from the actions panel over on the right hand side. So if the panel's not showing, just click that arrow and it will bring up the actions. Now the first thing we're going to do is create a new set. So using this icon, which is a folder icon, which says create new set, we're going to create a new set and give it a name. So we're going to put this as Huawei P20 vignette. Click OK. And now within that, we're going to create a new action. So click this tab, which says create new action. And we're going to call it removal. Now, when we click record, it will begin to record the sequences of events that we capture during the process. So if I click record, you now notice that the action panel has gone red here. It means that all the steps are being recorded. So whatever I do now in Photoshop will be recorded as an action. So the first thing I'm going to do is duplicate this layer. So right click on the layer, duplicate layer. You can leave it as background copy, that's fine. Now we've got a secure copy of our background, so we're not working destructively. Now the first thing we want to do is actually go into camera raw so we can actually do the adjustments. So if you go to filter and come down to camera raw filter, the camera raw will open up just as it would if you open that DNG file direct. But now we need to make the adjustments to remove this cyan green outside edge. Now the first thing I'm going to do is to use the lens profile, which is the one that's highlighted on the screen at the moment. So lens correction, and you've got the option to change vignetting. Now vignetting changes the way the screen center to edge is recorded. So the vignette control allows us to change the way that the outside corners are presented to us. So I'm going to move the vignette control up until you can see those corners going lighter and lighter up to the point where they stop, and then they actually start to go lighter still. So we're now over exaggerating the vignette control. So I'm going to keep it around about there. 36 or 40 is an ideal place for this particular vignette. Now the midpoint alters the way that the corners are recorded. So we're going to move this all the way down to zero to maximize the effect of the midpoint control. And now to change the outside appearance of the center, we're using a radial filter. So radial filter is the one here on the top toolbar. So click that and then set your center point in the center of your hotspot. Then you can draw on the screen the area that is considered, or you consider as being the hotspot. Now it's got the previous settings that I've had in there from the previous actions. I'm going to just take that down to zero, and you can see we've got a feather control first of all, and that allows us to feather out the area from the center to the edge. We're working on the outside area by default, so that is going to affect this outside area of the screen, so that's fine. So we want to move the feather to give us a nice transition between the hot spot in the middle and the existing area. So I'm going to say something like 60 is ideal. And now we want to change the appearance of this cyan green outside, and we can do that using the temperature, the tint, and the exposure control. Now by default, if there was no exposure compensation here, this is how the frame would appear. It's slightly darker on the outside edge, so I'm going to apply some exposure compensation to the outside edges, and it's roughly about a stop or 1 EV, so between 1 and 1.2 is a good point. So we've got similar density between the center and the edge. Now we're going to try and remove that color cast. So we've got control of the temperature between the blue and the yellow, and you want to make that as evenly as possible. So that is blue, that is yellowy. So we're going to end up with a value of about 17, which looks good. It's better to be on the slightly warmer side than the colder side. Now we've got the same option here with the tint control, which goes between green and magenta. And we're going to use this magenta to cancel out the green that's on the screen. So something about there, between 20 in the temperature and 58 or 60 in the tint. Now we're happy with the way that the screen works. You're never going to get this equal all over, but that's a good good starting point. When you finish with that, click OK, and that will take us back up to Photoshop, and you can see that it's applied that to that image for us. Now that's the end of this particular action sequence, so we need to stop the recording of the macro. So again, click the stop. And that is the end of the process. So we've now got a set of actions here, which is the vignette for the Huawei P20. So if we just come up to that point, we're ready to run an action. So we'll bring in the first image, which is that one of Rivington Hall. Now I'm going to play that action. So with our cursor set to the first step of the action, which is removal of the Huawei P20 vignette set we created, when I press the play button, the Photoshop will now run that set of actions we created for this removal. So when I press play, it will run those camera raw actions. And you can see that it's now brought back a pretty decent image from that very heavily cyan green image. And if I look at the second image, which was the car park, notice here we've got this heavy cyan green at the bottom. Again, press play, and that will take us through and remove those side edges and completely eliminate them. So that's the set we've just created. You can use those defaults that I've given you from my download folder, and I'll give you a link to that if you want to try them with your P20, or you can actually create your own set of actions. Anyway, that's it for this video. Thanks very much for watching. Please do click the subscribe button if you're a new viewer to the channel, and then the bell notification icon, and you'll be advised when I've uploaded any new videos to this series. Have a look at my photographic blog. There's a link to that again in the video description below. And on the homepage is my application to join the 3-weekly newsletter. And that newsletter is a complete technical publication in its own right. It's a way of saying thank you for joining that newsletter group, and it's information that I don't normally publish within the blog itself. So have a look at that, have a look at the archives and see what you think. So until my next video, thanks again for watching. Please do take care, and I hope to see you all in the next one. Goodbye for now.